calificas para ser legal. ¿Quieres saber? Solo llama al abogado Andrés Mejer.
Now, second big topic that we're going to talk about today, birthright citizenship. Lo and behold, Trump wants to eliminate it. Why is that? That's a darn good question. What does he really want to achieve by eliminating birthright citizenship? What is birthright citizenship? It's a legal right to citizenship, U.S. citizenship, for all children born in the country's territory, regardless of parents' legal status. So if I'm an immigrant and I'm undocumented and I have a child in the U.S., my child will be a U.S. citizen, period. My citizenship doesn't matter as long as my child is born in the U.S. So it doesn't matter if I go to Chile and I have a child, that child will be a U.S. citizen because I'm a U.S. citizen today. What happens if I'm not a U.S. citizen? Well, what happens if I'm a green card? Does my child get citizenship? Or if I'm here on a student visa? Or if I'm here on a work visa? Or if I'm here on a sports visa? Whatever the visa is, if I'm here for a temporary period of time and I'm not a U.S. citizen, but I have a child here, is my son or daughter a U.S. citizen? That's the question that Trump is raising. He says they should not be, period. So where does this birthright citizenship come from? It comes from English common law. It was established in the 1600s and brought over to the colonies. There are over 30 countries, actually I think there are exactly 30 countries that have birthright citizenship. The U.S. is by no means the only one. In the U.S., birthright citizenship came to focus on race and slavery because the African Americans that were slaves were not considered citizens. They had no rights whatsoever. They were property. So in 1868, they created the 14th Amendment to the U.S. Constitution specifically to give the African American ex-slaves citizenship. So now, born in the U.S. means you're a U.S. citizen, with small exceptions. If I'm a diplomat, let's say I'm the Chilean ambassador to the U.S. I come here for a four-year trip, and during that time, my wife and I have a child. My child will not be a U.S. citizen just by virtue of my diplomatic status. Same thing, if I'm a member of an occupying army, so imagine Chile becomes a real military powerhouse and decides, New Jersey, we're gonna annex it. They come in, they take over, they take the state of New Jersey. State of New Jersey is now part of Chile. Imagine that. If I'm part of that occupying army and I have a child here, my child is not a U.S. citizen. And lastly, it's Indians under tribal government. So the idea is neither of these three are under the subject to the jurisdiction of the U.S. That is the clause that Trump wants to focus on by saying undocumented immigrants also are not subject to the jurisdiction of the U.S. and therefore no U.S. citizenship. Now, they pay taxes, a variety of different ways. Their kids go to school, they use the roads, they face criminal charges if they're charged with a crime. It's gonna be hard for the president to say not subject to the jurisdiction of the U.S. Congress will not pass a bill. There isn't enough support. I don't even think there's enough Republicans that want to pass it alone. That even forget the Democrats for a moment. Although Trump and others like him say, immigrants come here, have children just to stay. The reality is a child born here, with few exceptions, will have to wait 21 years to file for me. And even if they do, unless they're in the military, I'm not able to adjust my status if I entered illegally. The only way to be able to certainly, 100% of the time, remove birthright citizenship is to amend the Constitution. How do you do that? Two ways. One, you need a 66% majority of both the House and the Senate. Now, if you take all the House and the Senate and you put them outside and you ask them what color the sky is, 66% of them will not agree on the color. One will say green, one will say gray, when in reality is it's blue. That's just what's going on in our political culture. It is unfortunate, but it is a reality. 2/3 of all members of the House and all senators have to agree on an amendment to the Constitution, or through a constitutional convention called by 66% of the state legislatures. That is not going to happen at the moment, certainly not on this issue. Any questions or comments, please indicate below. If there's something you want us to talk about in the future, indicate it below.